आज जिस हालात के अंदर जो पूरा दुनिया गुजर रहा है कोविड की मामले में, मेरा मानना है कि जो पाकिस्तान की रवैया है उसके अंदर कोई बदलाव नहीं आया है। और इस तरफ की जो हरकतें हैं, जहां इन्फिल्ट्रेशन हो रहा है, सीज फायर वॉलेशन हो रहा है, वो बहुत ही शर्मनाक और निंदाजनक है। सो आई थिंक पाकिस्तान नीड्स टू चेंज इट्स बिहेवियर एंड गेट डाउन टू हार्श रियलिटीज सो दैट वी बोथ आर एबल टू फाइट कोविड इन आर ओन वेज।
ग्राउंड पे आप पाकिस्तान सेना के एटीट्यूड और डिप्लॉयमेंट में क्या किसी तरह का कोई अंतर देख रहे हैं कोविड-19 को लेकर?
आई डू नॉट सी अ वेरी मेजर चेंज इन दी पैटर्न ऑफ डिप्लॉयमेंट बट वी डू गेट इंटेलिजेंस इनपुट फ्रॉम अक्रॉस दैट यू नो पाकिस्तान इज पुशिंग अ लॉट ऑफ द कोविड केसेस इनटू पाकिस्तान ऑक्युपाइड जम्मू एंड कश्मीर। But we have also reason to believe they're underplaying the numbers that are actually, you know, getting affected on the other side. We are also conscious that Pakistan is taking risk of putting these, gullible people who are being trained as mujahideen or being trained as terrorists into very small enclosed places in their own launch pads. So we are very conscious that, you know, these people who could be coming from across could be carriers of COVID themselves. So we are very conscious of the way we are going to handle the terrorist bodies, you know, whenever they are killed.
जब आपने कहा कि पाकिस्तान अफेक्टेड कोविड अफेक्टेड लोगों को सीमा के नजदीक के इलाकों में पुश कर रहा है, तो ये इसका क्या मतलब है? इसका क्या प्रूफ है कि पाकिस्तान ऐसा कर रहा है?
This is based on intelligence input, and I would like to restrict myself there. But definitely, we have reason to believe that you know, from the areas of Punjab, they are putting them into the outer, you know, far lying areas where hopefully the you know this density of population is slightly less. So we have reason to believe that there are quarantine centers which have been set up in this particular area.
तो लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल पे एक इतनी अलग दुनिया क्यों है जब पूरी दुनिया कोविड 19 को लेकर जूझ रही है?
While I would like to focus my attention on the happenings within the country in terms of ensuring peace and tranquility in the valley, in terms of you know helping our own people and the civil administration as far as COVID management is concerned, but I, as the military commander on ground, have to ensure that the line of control sanctity is maintained, and any attempts by any power to you know push an infiltration is taken care of. So technically, I am fighting both the battles, and we are prepared for this.
कोविड-19 से आपकी खुद की डिप्लॉयमेंट, आपके खुद के ऑपरेशनल प्रोसीजर्स में किस तरह की चुनौतियां आई हैं, किस तरह के फर्क आपने देखे हैं?
Firstly, upfront, I would like to say that right now in my complete core zone, we do not have a single case of COVID. So we would like to maintain this, you know, separation for a little while. Along the line of control, I presume we are the safest, you know. Today we are looking at these people, you know, 50% of my troops are cut off from, you know, the basic road communication. They're all still in the self, sustaining mode. So I think from my side, this population which is deployed along the line of control are the happiest in terms of COVID, because technically there is nobody who can kind of contact them. The only threat is of somebody coming from across the line of control.
घुसपैठ की खबर थी जिसके बाद भारतीय सेना ने वहां पर अपनी काफी ताकत लगाई, स्पेशल फोर्सेस तक इस ऑपरेशन में उतारे गए। इस ऑपरेशन के बारे में आप हमें क्या बता सकते हैं जनरल राजू?
The Karan operation was not a unique operation, जिसके अंदर मौसम के हालात को you know उसके फायदा उठाते हुए एक घुसपैठियों ने 1 अप्रैल को अंदर आने की कोशिश किया था। The issue is that they used the bad weather, they used the challenging terrain to their advantage, you know, and on that particular day it was slightly snowing. I thought it was very disingenuous on the part of Pakistan to, you know, raise the ante at this particular time.
Special forces ki itni badi matra mein casualty hona, ye ek bahut hi badi aur ek kahin na kahin ek shocking baat bhi thi. Koi analysis bhi ho raha hai ki kis tarah se shayad itni badi casualty na ho fir se.
These are operational hazards. Yes, we are definitely looking into, you know, looking into the matter. But our preliminary, you know, analysis of the situation says that it is. It is an act of God, if I can say, where at that particular moment, at that juncture, they encountered a situation which was beyond their control. I said it is an accident, but yes, we as military men should be able to absorb such debacles whenever they happen.